Now the floor goes to Martina Dlabajova with one sentence. Without skills, the game is over.
Thank you very much, Arnaldo. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's quite difficult speaking after a president of this house. Maybe I should try to speak in Italian to be so emotional as he was, but I will try to speak in English and be emotional as well. So my name is Martina Dlabajova. I am a Czech member of the European Parliament. I am a member of the ALDE group, and I am a member of the Employment and Social Affairs Committee. Well, I must thank to Eurochambers that is always inviting me for this great event, and I think it's very useful for all of us, for me and for you, to be together in this plenary hemicycle. And, you know, 5 years ago, I would have been sitting there, because before joining this parliament, I was a businesswoman, and I would have been sitting in your rows, listening to some boring politicians, maybe. And now the rules change. I still feel more businesswoman than a member of the European Parliament, still more in business than in politics, which can be helpful for you. But I think that one day that Eurochambers will stop to invite me for this event, it means that I will become a politician. I hope you will never stop to invite me. Well, the question of skills and jobs match and youth employment and skills for our young generation, it has been very dear to my heart even before joining the European Parliament. And now, more than ever, I am realizing fast and many changes, a world which is characterized by globalization, digitalization, interconnection, new ways of working, new ways of labor contracts. And due to the technological advances, skills that we teach at school today might be redundant tomorrow. So now, where is the problem and what can we change? I believe that this problem is rooted in our current education policy framework, and we should push on our education institution to be as well socially responsible as companies and businesses are socially responsible. We should help our schools and educative institutions not to have trouble adapting to the real needs of today's and tomorrow's labor market. For now, it looks like sometimes the schools are not able to provide and equip young people with skills that are required by their potential employers. And you, as employers, have to help them to give right skills to young people. Of course, there are so many good examples in Europe. There are great examples of cooperation between schools and businesses, especially in some member states with the dual learning systems, for example. However, there is not a system. We are missing some systematic approach in Europe on this topic. Today, we know that about 40% of companies are struggling to find qualified staff. And imagine that the same number, 40% of young people, are working in different sector than the sector they're studied for. So there is something wrong somehow. And the unemployment rate among young people is even more worrying, because people aged 18, 25 years in Europe, imagine that in some member states we have unemployment rate of 50%. In some regions, especially in South Europe, we have even 60% of unemployment among young people. And this is really worrying me. We know that there are new trends of key skills demand, and we are demanding more and more manual skills and physical abilities. But on the other side, there is an increase of importance of analytic thinking, innovation, creativity, and active learning strategies. There is increased demand on so-called soft skills. I'm always joking why we call these skills soft, because they are the hardest to get, but we call them soft. According to the OECD, 9% of jobs will completely disappear because of robotization and digitalization. I would love to hear your opinion on this, because of course we know that jobs will change, professions will change, there will be new jobs, and people will need to be more flexible and they will need to use adaptability in their profession career. Of course, we will see all these significant changes, and I think that we should not be skeptical. We should think ahead and prepare ourselves, our labour markets and our workforce for this change, because the change is coming, and it is just up to us if it will be a good or bad change. Employers through Europe implement different strategies how to tackle the challenge of shifting skills demand. Some choose to prefer hiring new permanent staff rather than to invest into their current staff retraining. Some will choose the way out of outsourcing. There are so many different approaches, and it will be interesting to hear your best practices, because this is why we are here. We should see all possible strategies and the best ways to cooperate between businesses, institutions and universities. Every time I speak to entrepreneurs, every time the main topic, the main worry is skills mismatch and it's unemployment and the change on labor market for the future. It's the main topic I'm always discussing with business people. So I believe the way of sharing best practices like today, listen to the needs and proposals from your side, are important for all of us to make the change together. And we should turn it into the opportunity. As I said, maybe one of the ways will be to reform the logic of our current education systems. I launched idea already 3 years ago to start something like corporate social responsibility for schools and educational institutions as well. Why just businesses should be corporately social responsible? The schools and education systems should be responsible as well, because they are responsible for the skills they are giving to your employees and to young generation. It will be the future workforce in Europe. My last point, it's about entrepreneurship education. Where to speak about entrepreneurship education if not here with you? You all know what does it mean. It doesn't mean that everybody will be in business. It doesn't mean that everybody will start up a company. It means that people can become a free thinker, problem solver, innovative, they can take risks. Entrepreneurial education is about approach to life and being active in life. So I think this is something we should promote in our schools. So, of course, we are here in a group of people who try and usually succeed to think outside of the box and outside of the pre-established frameworks. So we should find the solutions together. We should find efficient ways of doing things. So please share with us your ideas, and I promise you that we are here to listen. You know, my first event as a politician, as a member of the European Parliament 4 years ago, was, of course, with people from business. It was here in Brussels in 2014, and I was going to the podium to speak, my first speech. Very strange role, because you are a business person the whole life, then you jump into the politics, and you need to speak to business people. So I asked the people around the table, who were all in big businesses, hey guys, what do you want to hear from me? What do you want from me? How can a politician help the businesses in Europe? You know what was the answer? They looked at me and they said, well, don't do nothing, just listen to us. And I just want to assure you that in this house, in your places where we are sitting and where we are voting in the plenaries, there are so many politicians who are really willing to listen to you. So don't give up to talk to policymakers, to share your ideas, because we are really here to listen. Thank you so much and good luck for the whole event.
Thank you very much, Martina Dlabajova.